I requested this meeting in order to make you a proposition. In my opinion, your company manufactures the finest automobile in the world. The automobile represents progress in the most profound sense of the word. The ultimate example of American ingenuity and enterprise. This great nation cannot take a backseat to competitors like Daimler, Mercedes, Napier, Rolls-Royce, the Dietrich or Panhard. Gentlemen, I propose to prove that the American automobile, your automobile, is without peers.
And just how do you propose to prove that, sir?
A race.
Really, sir, you surprise me. Automobile races are becoming most commonplace.
I mean a long race. A very long race.
Buffalo to Albany? It's been done.
Chicago to Cleveland? That's been done.
New York? To Paris.
New York to
Paris?
You must build an automobile to the most precise specifications.
No. Absolutely no. For a company of this repute, a great company the likes of this, trusting its entire automobile future to the man the likes of Leslie, it's disreputable. A cheap carnival performer, a fraud, a trickster. You hear? A madman.
Apologize.
Pulling it out by the roots, you see, I warned you. The madman, did you see him trying to pull me beard out right by the roots? Leslie will lose. Your automobile will lose. I will win.
He jumped.
I shall build the greatest automobile in the world, and I shall win!
Okay, Professor!
This time it will not be Leslie, it will be I, Professor Fate! Fate the Magnificent!
Ah! No!